Hallelujah. 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 It is crazy worship like this that draws the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's worship like this that draws the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A small announcement. Our walls are charged with fire tonight. Hallelujah. Our ground is charged with fire tonight. Hallelujah. The fire of the living God is in the springs. Hallelujah. And nothing.
Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Judah. And Canaan before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it." But the man that went up with him said, "We be not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we." And they brought up an evil report of the land which they had said unto the children of Israel, saying, "The land through which we have gone to search it is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof, and all the people that we saw in it are men of a great stature. And there we saw the giants, the son of Anak, which come of the giants, and we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we were in their sight."
Hallelujah. Thank you. Let's read the book of Jonah 1. As the person paying the keyboard to come back again, I want you to assist me. I'm not going to say it wrong.
Jonah chapter 1, verse 1.
First one, yes.
"Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa."
Amen. Thank you. 2 Samuel 12, verse 16.
2 Samuel chapter 12, verse 16. It reads as follows. "David, therefore, besought God for the child. And David fasted and went in and lay all night upon the earth. And the elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the earth. But he would not, neither did he eat bread with them."
Hallelujah. 1 Kings 19, verse 2.
1 Kings chapter 19, verse 2. "Then Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah, saying, So let the gods do to me, and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time."
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before I preach, I'd like to thank my spiritual father, Pastor Mangani. He has grown me and made me the person I am today. Hallelujah. Can you please pray for the word of the Lord?
So if this word is received by one person, then
I was called to minister somewhere, it was a big conference, and I went and I was begging my mom, can you please come with me, please come with me. She was like, okay, I'll see. And then she ended up coming with me. We went to church, church was fine. It was this big congregation, more than 1,000 of people. And they prayed for the sick, and I was up on the stage, I was ministering. And a few seconds later, they called me, they're like, your mom is down. And I was wondering what could have happened. I went down to check what had happened. My mom was gasping. And in this moment, I'm sure 90% of the congregation were like, pray for her. Hallelujah. 90% of the congregation expected prayer to work. And unfortunately, prayer didn't work. And we lost her on the spot. Hallelujah. It was the most trying time of my life because I had to make a decision whether to go on serving God or quit. Hallelujah. All eyes were on me. They're like, okay, she's ministering the word. But the mother died on the spot. Hallelujah. And because of emotions,
procedure, or it's fighting against yours.
you wouldn't have gotten there.